Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Let's go back to Patrick's question from Tuesday. Patrick sent a new note and said, hey, that worked out great creating the SUMIF function over here to figure out the total for department. He says, but you know, at the beginning of the month, I may not have done work for all the departments, so I end up with all these departments that have zeros, and it's just showing up in the pie chart. They're stacked up, or sometimes you know, they're actually on top of each other. Is there any way to get the zero departments out of the pie chart? Well, there's two ways to do this. The first is to turn on AutoFilter, data filter, AutoFilter, and we'll go in and say we want a custom filter basically where the data does not equal zero. And when you hide something because of an AutoFilter, what happens is it gets hidden from the chart. Now, the problem with this is it's actually destroying some of our data over here on the left-hand side. So there's a much more difficult way to do this automatically where we will never have to go through an AutoFilter. Basically, I said we're going to come over here to column F to the left of our data and add a rank function in. Basically, I say, hey, I want the rank of this value in H4 amongst all the values from H4 to H10. Now, sometimes we're going to end up with ties. And so when we end up with a tie in the later functions, we're also going to add a count of how many times this particular number of hours has already appeared before me. And what that does is even though there's a tie here with two departments, both at 0 hours, it's showing up as a rank of 6 and a rank of 7. It's important that we have every value represented. Now I came over here to the right-hand side and put in the numbers from 1 through 7 because I had 7 departments, and then used basically a VLOOKUP, said, hey, go find whichever value is ranked number one today. So that ends up the TRF department with 3.3. Grab their total also using a VLOOKUP. So now I have an interesting table over here on the right-hand side that basically sorts the data. So that way the largest values are at the top and their hours, and I have several values that are zero at the end. Now this is where it gets kind of tricky. I came over here to column N and created a COUNTIF function, said, hey, I want to count every cell that's greater than zero, so that way I know that I only have, in this case, 5 cells today. And you'll see that this would change if I would add a new value in. Now I have 6 values that are non-zero. I went into insert name define and set up a dynamic range. We've talked about this on the podcast before. Basically it says, hey, we're going to start from this cell right here, cell K2, go down 0 rows and right 0 rows, but then how many rows do I want to include in the range? Well, hey, I want to include whatever the answer is over here in N3 plus 1 for the headings, and then finally make it be 2 columns wide. I then went in and basically created a chart. Instead of specifying that source data, I then created the chart based on my data, and that creates a dynamic chart. So if we have several departments that are 0 over here, they automatically fall out of the chart. As the month goes on and we get more data, it automatically gets added back into the chart. So you know, this takes a good 5, 6, 7 minutes to get it set up once, but once you have it set up, then it'll work perfectly for the rest of the time. You won't have to go in and reapply the auto filter to get rid of the non-zero values every single day. A couple of ways to go. Auto filter, certainly easier to do, but if you're going to have to produce this report every day, probably worth the time to add the extra columns, the rank, the VLOOKUPs, and then the count if. Finally, the dynamic range name to make sure that it only charts the values that are non-zero. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.